Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
IIM A provides a very good platform to corporates. Many of them probably get a job before even getting through entering the first session. But right. but in general, I think students realize that all the courses and how they are designed are meant for transforming how they think.
You've done manufacturing engineering, you know, and then you've done an MSc in supply chain management, and then you've also done an MSc in manufacturing systems engineering. So, you know, often it happens that, you know, you're not sure sometimes what is the route that you want to take. But is this how you figured that, okay, this is the journey? How did you figure out this is the journey you want to undertake in terms of your education?
So I come from a very middle class family, like most of us do, probably from a lower middle class. And the only profession we knew to aspire was to either becoming a doctor or an engineer. So I was also inspired by the hotel management profession, by the way. Being good with numbers, I chose engineering. So while I was doing my engineering in 1999, I received the Young Engineering Fellowship from IISc Bangalore. Today it is known as the KVPY. You probably heard that KVPY. So, and that internship really opened the world for me. So I was there for 2 months while India was fighting the Kargil war that year, the same month actually. So till that point, I didn't really know of IISc as an institute. But as I went there, I was quite impressed by the infrastructure, by the atmosphere. I said, I have to go there again. So that's when I started more seriously preparing to get into IISc the following year. And I joined in 2000 the MSc research program in management studies the following year.
So you teach students these days who, after finishing their education, immediately will be joining at salaries upwards of 25 lakhs, 30 lakhs. My best understanding of academics, at least in India, is that they're not paid that well. So when you see that, do you feel any kind of regret that maybe, you know, instead of pursuing a PhD, maybe I should have done a postgraduate business degree, and, you know, at least in terms of salary, it would have been, the starting salaries are very different.
This question would be very apt if you'd ask this question maybe before the 6th pay commission, right? But okay. Today, after the 6th pay and 7th pay commission, I think faculties are paid very, very handsomely. I think government is taking very good care of the faculties.
In India, enough people don't take up academic careers because the lure of money, at least for the ones who are not in government institutions, is very high to go into the industry rather than going into academics.
General phenomena is quite kind of similar. In fact, in India, people even categorize the profession of teaching as the last career. So you probably didn't make it anywhere and you got into teaching, right? And it also could be that if you're teaching, probably you have to do some kind of extra work to get some extra money and so on and so forth. But in general, I think I have no regret. I started my career in Netherlands in teaching, and then I moved back to India. So money was never a kind of a showstopper here. Just kindly the passion for teaching and a good kind of environment, and that can really groom you as a faculty. In India as such, at least at IIMA, we have a very strong kind of connect to the practice. We have a excellent research environment, and we also have a very good teaching rigor. So I think we are really getting all the three dimensions right, which is required in kind of in any business school. So if it wasn't IIMA, probably I would have also been in teaching or in academics, but probably in another country.
Can you tell me three reasons why IIMA has been top of the pack for so many years in India as far as business education is concerned? What are the things that IIMA gets right in your opinion?
So I think IIMA one is, of course, their selection process is so nicely done. It's so waterproof, I would say, that our students who come to the program are really whom we want to groom. So I think our input process is extremely robust, I would say. And that really puts the demand on the faculty as well, because if our students are so nice, our faculty has no option but to give their best in the classes. And that also results in a very nice interaction between faculty and students. And at the end, you get a fantastic product out of the institute because they're well prepared to handle the kind of requirements that the environment pushes on us. And I say that because, you know, IIMA is mostly a case-based pedagogy institute, and we try to deliver all the concepts using real cases. And that puts a very nice kind of rigor with our participants, because they know that any kind of environment we have, what kind of situation we are put in, we know how to get out of that. But I also see our students at the end are very capable of seeing the big picture. And that really comes handy when they want to take any risk in life as well. They're able to gauge both the positive things, what are the kind of the consequences, and they take very informed decisions. And that's what I've seen over the years. And that also is kind of a challenge, but also a kind of reason to develop our teaching methods, because when we teach, we're not teaching now anymore only engineers, but we have lawyer, we have medicine people, we have people, dentists, we have artists, we have a variety of kind of people, and our courses should suit everyone at the same time, right? So I think we are on the right trajectory as such.
A professor, how do you pick a case that you want to take to the classroom? What are some of the things that a real life case should definitely have for it to qualify to be discussed in your classroom?
So one, the case I prefer, of course, the cases could be a variety of, it could have large variation.
Right.
But if it is an operations management case, I would rather choose with a strong focus in the product in mind, right? So whether it is an engineering product or it is a consumer product, so the product focus has to be strong, and it should be linked to the learnings that I want to provide through this particular session. So I choose the case particularly looking at learning objectives of the case. And of course, if the product has a easy focus and easy to understand, it's even better.
What's it like teaching the cream of India's students?
IIMA students are of course, they're very, very, they're robust in their thinking. They think in multiple dimensions. They analyze the trade-offs pretty well. So I think while teaching before, so we have to really be ready about what kind of what are the passages we're going to cover in the class, and the organization of the session should be well defined. So we put a ton of effort before going to the class so that every one of them has a good learning experience. So we spend time on that. If you refer to how difficult it was, I think teaching in general is a very fascinating profession. So it's not difficult. I would say it's slightly more involved. You should really have a good presence of mind while you're in the session.
A lot of them come with, career first rankers. All of them are like first rank in all their academic pursuits. And they come to the classroom and they challenge you around something that you're teaching. How do you go about handling those things? Because some of them might tend to have a chip on their shoulder.
Yeah, so for instance, there are many instances. For example, I talk about, say, the customers may think in this particular way. So customers, for example, when you talk about, say, Christian's cookies is a famous case that we talk about, which is a small case, but it talks about the how do you set your processes right to get the product to the customer. So if we make assumption, for instance, saying that the cookie is prepared in a small tray with 12 cookies. And the students come and say, hey, it's not like that. We actually prepared in a large tray. Okay, so it could be those kind of smaller issues. But it could also be like, we say that customers are willing to wait. And students say, hey, usually for cookies, we are not willing to wait, right? So those kind of assumptions, of course, we make. And then we also say in the class saying that, hey, while we make some assumptions for getting the learnings right, the disclaimer is that in practice, many things could go haywire, right? So we set the grounds just to deliver the learnings, and we make a few assumptions on the way just to simplify our thoughts.
In terms of the pool of students that IIMA tends to attract, what is the difference between those students and students that you see in universities abroad?
That's a tough question because you asked me to compare now. I will generally say what I like about IMA students in general. What I like is the students, whatever background they come from, very diverse background, right? As I mentioned earlier, from commerce to arts to philosophy to lawyer to dentist to medicine. So we have every kind of profession in the class. But all of them at the end of the kind of course or at the end of the program, they are able to see the big picture. The students are often willing to take risks in their life, especially in the early part of their life, and try to make a difference to the society.
So generally about the MBA, there is this always this confusion where certain set of students are more placements oriented versus certain set of students who are more academically oriented. So where do you stand on that? How do you think the students should approach that? Because obviously MBA is also about prioritizing, right? You have a limited amount of time and you have to prioritize what are the things that you should focus on.
I think students should, of course, IMA provides a very good platform to corporates. Many of them probably get a job before even getting through entering the first session. But right. But in general, I think students realize that all the courses and how they are designed are meant for transforming how they think, right? At least I would say 50% of our students are completely fresh who do not have any kind of practical exposure a priori, other than maybe a few internships here and there. So I would say for everyone, including the one who are coming so fresh to our institute, the courses should be emphasized more. While the job is kind of certain, you will get a good job, hopefully according to your preferences. But then you should also focus on all the courses because they are nicely intertwined to deliver the learning. And with this 500, 600 cases you're doing every year, it's more like an corporate experience for 10, 20 years squeezed in 1 year.
Thank you so much for doing this, sir.
Thank you so much.